Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very sorry that I'm not with you in Trondheim at this first energy clustering event, but I'm with you with my ideas and with my spirit. Now, I would like to say a few words about as I see energy, myself being a physicist and not having forgotten all my physics. And then, of course, wish you a marvelous time in Trondheim. Now, energy, there is first the energy production, that's to say, production of low entropy, usable energy. Then there is the transmission of energy. Then you have, of course, the storage of energy. Then you have the use of energy. And eventually you have the disposal of energy, or whatever you have to dispose of. This is well known to those who know the world of energy. And of course, it has aspects which have to do with science, aspects which have to do with technology, and that is very important, not to forget the societal issues. Particularly, well, no, I would say in all five stages. Now, you know very well we get energy from the sun, which is a very low entropy, so a valuable energy, and eventually we get rid of it when it leaves in the form of infrared radiation our planet. So we have to make sure that the atmosphere is transparent to infrared radiation so that we can close the circle in a correct way. Now, this is the classical view of what energy means, and in each one of these sectors, as I said, you know, we need bright people with ideas, people who know the technology, and then, of course, you know, contact with the society. We need students to deal with these things. We have to teach them. We need PhD candidates. We need postdocs. We need researchers to deal with all these issues. There is nevertheless, I would say today, a slightly different perspective to the whole thing, which is exactly the same which you have in other areas. And that is to say, we have to look at it globally. It's probably not anymore a good way of looking at it partially in each one of these steps. Although we need people who are experts in each one of the steps, but we need a systemic approach. We need to look at it globally if we really want to be able to advance. Advancement will come with, you know, little new ideas and with breakthroughs. But this is exactly what you have in universities. And in the universities, we have all of this. We have the science, we have the technology, and we have the knowledge of society, and we have the teaching and learning. We have the training of the people who can deal with all these things. So I'm very happy to welcome you. I'm very happy to tell you that this is very likely one of the most important issues which we have as human beings. And you know very well that if we have solved correctly the energy issues, then very many of the other problems which we have on our planet will be solved also. The water problem, certainly, the food problem, and so on. So I wish you a great time in Trondheim. I wish you lots of success. And I promise to you that I will be with you in one of the next events, which you are going to organize while being in Trondheim. Have a very nice day. Bye-bye.